Parental discretion is advised.
Remix!
Hey guys, it's the Wrestling Mayhem Show. I don't even know what number it is. 303. And we're back in here. This is the 6th anniversary episode.
And you're all fired.
And we're starting over.
Get out of the room. You're all fired.
Is that it?
I'm not even in the room.
I know, but you're still fired.
I'm in a different room.
Yes, get up, put down the microphone, and walk away from the computer.
I'm at plus 5 against firing, so you can shove that up your pee hole.
Rolled a 20.
That's DJ Lunchbox from a new location.
No.
Same location, different room in the house.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Seriously, 6 years. We've been doing this for 6 fucking years. It's beautiful.
I still think we should have stopped after the first one.
The child born at the beginning of this show is now in second grade.
And there he is, Bo Diggity, joining us once again.
Bo Diggity is here! Say it out loud. I just say it with my voice and my full volume voice.
And coming at us from, I think he's still in Corpus Christi, Texas.
Yes, yes, indeed. I'm a Russell fan, and I've got the funk.
Wow.
Ow. You pointed out there.
If I didn't already fire you, you would be fired now.
Which you did.
And on the counts is Mr. Chachi of ChachiPlays.com.
You would be fired. You're all fired. ChachiPlays.com. Go over. Click the little donate button.
I'll just take my healthy donation to ChachiPlays.com.
Toss the kids some money. It's for the kids.
Toss the kids.
For the kids.
There you go.
You know what? I have the perfect pitch for it, and I figured that out earlier today.
Okay.
If you like video games,
mm-hmm.
or that handy little game on your iPhone or Android device that you like to play, that would not be possible without art, and it starts with the children.
There you go.
So
exactly.
Go to ChachiPlays.com, hit that donate button, toss us a few bucks.
Hit it.
Do it.
And also joining us from south of Pittsburgh is Hot Wheels.
Hey, folks, what's up?
Yeah, on to help us through that display we saw last night.
Oh, God, it was horrible.
And now the time you've all been waiting for.
No one's been waiting for
the reveal of our special guest for this week. Steam Machine rejoins us.
How's it going, guys?
You're also fired.
Oh, my God.
I'm sure absolutely everyone missed me.
You're also fired.
You're not paying me.
No one's getting paid.
I think you have to pay me to fire me.
No, completely not.
Well, also, think about it this way. I am sitting on the couch with you, and whenever I'm unemployed, I feel the need to touch the person closest to me as much as possible. Deeply as possible.
Fair enough.
Have fun, Chachi.
All right, so Esteem and I are the only two people left with jobs in the room. And you can go ahead and hang up on all those four people.
All right,
and I'm going to move over to the switcher.
So, Steam, it's been 4 years?
Yeah, I think about four. Yeah.
4 years. Where the hell have you been?
I have been... Well, whenever I stopped coming to the show, I was working 3 jobs in college, so that's a little rough. Mm-hmm. Other than that, it's really been no progress, no life advancement. It has been really we're hoping with my living situation that by the summer, if not next winter, I might be able to go from my room into my mother's basement. And I think that'll be, it's kind of cold down there though. But, that's
space
where we've
heaters.
Been. Yeah. Well, we're kind of worried about fire. So, but shit. I think there's a workout machine down there. So I could probably put on, 7-8 pounds of muscle.
There you go. There you go. Exactly. So he joins us here this week. Hey, it's a Wrestling Mayhem Show. Again, we've been doing this for 6 years, and how did you just find us? I don't know. Hey,
hold on.
Oh, what's up?
I have... wrong one. I have I have something. I've since there has been a tragedy since my last appearance here, the loss of the greatest wrestler of all time ever. I don't know. I imagine there was a big special.
The match.
But I have a thing.
Okay.
All right. Okay.
Okay.
Building dramatic.
Okay, gotcha.
Were you the best? Were you the champion? Will you be missed?
Oh, yeah.
That's all I got.
Okay.
I'm not a poet.
It works.
That was soft. That was way better than what we did.
Right. I was going to say. That was head and shoulders more touching above our entire episode.
20 seconds.
Yeah.
Yeah, but now we can go back to talking like boobs and stuff. That's fun.
Okay. Yeah. And make fun of WrestleFans Mall. Anyways, this is a Wrestling Mayhem show. You can find out more about us and all the blogs and everything that many contribute, including a few of the people behind me here, at WrestlingMayhemShow.com, including a nice Macho Man Skyrim video that surfaced over this past week.
Ooh.
So go check that out there. And, of course, you can email us at...
Good times at WrestlingMayhemShow.com.
Follow us on Twitter at Mayhem Show. You can also give us a call at 412-206-WMS0. That's 9670 on your rotary dial. And you can also follow us, like I mentioned, the Twitter. We're also on Facebook, have a page up there. And we're really pushing right now the Facebook open group. Join us. So we're dropping comments in there during Monday Night Raws, pay-per-views and stuff. Chachi doesn't join us because he's antisocial. And also, hey, we're on Google+. Plus us on there. And we're on iTunes. Drop us some comments. Blip TV, YouTube. Chachi's still flipping me off.
No
one else can see that. So I must inform them what's happening between the cameras. And also, we have a nifty iPhone app, which I think is over there on a tablet device right there. Look at that.
Yes, it is.
Wheels is sporting it on his Galaxy Tab 10-inch. That's where you get all your shows and extra content that we don't put anywhere else right now. Except once we put a couple in the best of show, but it's just a little sampling. We'll give you guys a little preview of that here coming up. So let's get right to it. And let's get right into the fan mail. I think somebody called this one from our new emailer. I think AJ.
Yes, I did. I did call this email. And it goes like this. Greetings, Mayhemers. Congrats on your 300th episode. I heard the WMS for the first time just a few months ago, and I was instantly hooked. You guys are all great. Yes, even you, WrestleFan. I look forward to every week. Keep doing your thing and bringing the awesome. Now the reason for this email. Chris Jericho. One word, brilliant. I was stunned. I say stunned! To hear even the mildest criticism of his return from the WMS crew. I would hope that after sitting through years of generic, scripted, pedestrian, routine, cookie-cutter wrestling angles, you would be ready to embrace something different for a change. I would also hope that the performer, the caliber of Chris Jericho, would have enough goodwill accumulated that you would be willing to at least give his unorthodox return 1 week. 1 week! To see where he was going with it. I know we live in a spoiler-filled society where we all know the plot for the movies before we go to see them, but do you really want to see Jericho lay out his entire agenda on his first night back? Aren't we the people who complain that the WWE doesn't know how to do a slow build? I've read how Jericho may be drawing inspiration for his current character from John Cena, the Dynamic Dudes, or others known for pandering to the audience. I think his real inspiration is his last comeback. Go back and watch.
We can just show the video.
K18WGAGPAHS.
There you go. For your video. Go on while this plays.
Then try to convince me that Monday night is somehow a step down. Instead of Jericho making a generic comeback with a generic face promo setting up an obvious and rushed title match with Randy Orton, we get intrigue and mystery. That's fine by me. This was more than Jericho slapping high five with the fans and occasionally going, oh yeah, all right, or come on, baby. Anybody can do that. This was one of the greatest performers of our generation challenging himself. There was no cheap heat here. Jericho was paying full price plus shipping and handling with his facial expressions and his body language. Point is, Chris Jericho knows what he's doing and he's creative enough to get us there in an interesting way. Sure, some may complain that WWE cheated the fans out of the payoff to 6 weeks of hype videos that ripped off the ring. But were you watching over the summer as this company butchered a slam dunk mainstream media angle with CM Punk? Blew it to hell beyond repair. This is the same company. There's a real good chance there's not a whole lot more going on with those videos. The girl means nothing. The swing set means nothing. The bouncing ball, nothing. I hope I'm wrong, but I accept reality. All that leaves for us as fans is to appreciate the individual performers, and I am damn sure appreciated what Jericho gave us Monday night. Something different for a change. Your friend in the mainstream media, at Matt Carlins.
There you go.
All right, I got the next one.
Okay.
What? You son of a bitch.
Do we not reply to these letters?
Do you have a response?
Yeah.
Go for it.
Go ahead.
I can't believe he's still alive. First off, he's been running with the Y2J thing now for 12, 13 years. I mean, hell, even friggin' Hulk Hogan made a little bit of a change around a little bit. But really? You like Jericho? You like Jericho? What is your problem?
Whoa.
He has two moves. Two moves. He has the Walls of Jericho,
mm-hmm.
which he's been using since biblical times. And then the thing where he jumps on the rope and then flips backwards.
I want to correct you right off the bat. We all know he's the man of 1,004 holds. So that's right true. Off well, the bat, you're wrong, your information is incorrect.
I don't care what he does in the bedroom.
That just gave a new definition to armbar.
No! Armbar!
Well, you should see the camel clutch there. Oh.
Oh.
But no, honestly, Jericho is such a friggin' second-class wrestler.
Whoa!
I'm sorry. I'm from WCW days whenever he had
where
he ended.
No, where he wasn't getting a push because people were pushing Hogan still.
No, he wasn't getting a push because he was garbage. And
no,
the only funny thing he ever did his entire career, the only thing that makes him people should talk about him is whenever he threw away the WCW TV championship because it couldn't get him free TV dinners.
You
were the one that loved WCW.
Absolutely.
He didn't throw away the TV title because it couldn't get TV dinners.
He literally threw it in a garbage can and they never showed it again.
Well, I think Duggan. Jim Duggan.
Well, that might have been whenever WCW was circling the drain.
man, the chat room's disagreeing as well with you.
Oh, I can't imagine they would.
No. So, I don't know how to respond to that.
You can't.
No.
He's completely wrong. Moving on.
Okay.
You are wrong because right now he's back with a great jacket. That everybody.
Right. How can you not like that jacket?
The jacket.
The blinky jacket he has going on?
Didn't he already have a blinky jacket?
Probably.
I'm pretty sure it's just his old WrestleMania one from 2000.
Right, which is greater than 7 years, therefore it's 11.
I thought he was also touring in Europe with Fozzy or something.
No, that tour ended in November. I did the math when the promo started.
God damn it. Can't he just do like. Did he do like Australia? Did they get.
I don't know.
I think they got it too. I think they got metal. I think. I think they got their fair share of metal.
Oh, okay,
I don't know. I could be wrong. I don't listen to metal. Wheels. I think this is where you come into play here, right?
Okay. Where
and go?
I don't know.
What? Chachi, you got the next mail there.
I do.
And
WMS! 6 years ago, a few things happened. I was 18 years old, legal in every state, ladies. Russell Fan was just a sparkle in the eye, or Kleenex, or something, I'm not too sure. Some other stuff happened. Then other stuff happened. And more stuff happened.
What?
And something happened. More filler, since I didn't do research. But also, the Wrestling Mayhem Show was born. Hell, back then, you guys liked TNA. Oh, how things have changed. However, I was thinking about why you guys lasted 6 years and what the fuck. How did you guys survive 6 fucking years? I mean, I've only been here for a few years now on the show since 2010, but you guys have struggled so long without me.
Well,
how the hell did you guys handle that? I mean, a little under 5 years without me? You know how much better your show is because I'm a critical aspect to this show. Anyways, I must say, I think the reason you guys lasted longer than most wrestling fan podcasts that are out there is because, well, you guys don't give a shit. There are times where the week has...
That's the secret!
The secret is lackadaisical care. That's what it comes down to, you guys.
Well, there are times where the week has been news heavy. There are times that there's no news. And if it was a normal wrestling podcast, would kill a normal wrestling show. But the fact that you guys have Mayhem once in a... Okay, more than once is the reason you guys have been going. Keep up the good work. By good work, I mean my throbbing erection.
What?
Riz.
My goodness.
Wow.
Wow. Oh, God, we're talking about penises again?
It wouldn't be.
Really,
it wouldn't
really
be
getting into some real ass penis talk right now. And not ass penis talk, because that would just be odd.
All right. Does anybody got dibs on Sonic here?
I'll take it.
See, okay. That's the one I was going to read, but Riz,
I knew what you were going to read.
Honestly, real quick, I think the secret to your success really falls back to well before anyone actually joined the show, and it was just you and or Chachi with 12 listeners.
That's very true.
Still going regardless.
That's very true.
Because if no one was listening or watching, we'd still be here.
Mr. DLB?
Ready?
Yeah.
Salutations, Mayhem Universe. Congratulations and happy anniversary to the podcast Ragnarok of the Wrestling Mayhem Show. Ragnarok. I've been listening for a year now and had the nerve to write in for a few months, but I have to say you guys have become the highlight of my week. You have my deepest gratitude for coming out every Tuesday and presenting your diatribe on professional wrestling.
High five.
I wish you guys longevity and good fortune throughout. I found my thesaurus again, by the way. Anyway, I have to hoist myself onto my soapbox and talk about the WWE. Instead of a highlight reel of SmackDown and Raw, I'm going to throw out a few questions. Number one. Is WWE trying to bury Brodus Clay? I haven't seen a worse gimmick since the Shockmaster or the Gobbledygooker. I can't in good conscience say anything bad about TNA after watching this. I am officially requesting a mayhem pardon for the total nonstop action wrestling.
Stop there.
Stop. For last year's writing in lieu of Brodus Clay, Fungusaurus.
Stop there.
We all disagree.
I was going to say, let's take a vote on it. All in favor of pardoning TNA?
Aye.
All opposed?
Nay.
Nay.
Pardon not carried.
That's fine.
Moving
on. You get my pardon.
Can I take another vote?
Sure.
Okay.
By a show of hands and then words following for our audio listeners, who thinks the Funkasaurus is the greatest thing that's ever happened?
Yeah.
It was so awkward. It was hilarious.
He was having such a good time. Look at that guy.
Can I be really honest? The creepiest move of the match is Kurt Hawkins kind of has him like a wrist lock from behind.
Oh,
in order to
yes.
break the hold, Brodus Clay just started grinding his ass into him.
Okay, I have to make a
break
statement
ever.
That. Friend of the show, Eric Ecstasy, said he stole my shit. Quote from his Facebook.
There you go.
Okay, but in all fairness, and I'm not saying anything against Eric, but yeah, that move would had been done way before then.
It's not new. It's like part Godfather, it's part Flash Funk. I think it was the first thing we said when they came out like this.
Well, because he had two bitches with him.
Shut up, Russell.
What is that, the Flash Funk part or the Godfather
part? Two dancing bitches.
And you're too young to be so disrespectful to women. Yes. No wonder you're not getting that cookie.
You call them ladies.
Exactly. They're very nice, nice ladies that don't know what a fucking good wrestling match is, like that one that told Stone Cold with Melina and whoever the fuck was their favorite match. You know? What?
Come on. I think it's Alicia Fox.
Alicia Fox? Yeah, that makes it better.
Yeah, exactly.
She wears dead things. Anyways, back to the email.
Wow. Number two. Is Daniel Bryan and Big Show trying to have a face-off? I'm sure Bryan will have to turn heel if he has any hope of retaining the title for any length of time. But why the flip-flopping? Asking for a rematch? Rematch? Having a fan-favorite diva girlfriend, but then committing celebratory, thank you. Wow, wrestle fan. Celebratory overindulgence and cheap heel tactics to win. I hope he uses the giant killer gimmick after he steals another win from the Big Show.
Oh, boy.
Number three.
That hasn't been done before.
Is Jericho channeling karma? Another no-go promo for the second week. Too emotional? The Ayatollah of rock and roll are too emotional. The cryptic clips built this up too good to drop it with no progression. The only other thing I want to comment is that you guys were talking about the boy and girl for the Jericho clips. I think they are the two people R-Truth is talking to when he looks behind him, but I'm just guessing. I bet their names are Jimmy and Jody, though. Congratulations again, and have a great show. Sonic Screwjob. P.S. If Cena played more Half-Life, he could have took care of Kane with that crowbar.
And there's a picture included. Yes.
This is for AJ.
This is for AJ. Should we read it to the audio listeners? I don't know.
It would kind of help.
I don't know. It kind of doesn't.
It's all over the place.
I can't even read it on the video. So
No, you're not going to be able to. So there's that.
All I know is it's hilarious.
It involves Star Wars and something about John Morrison and Slurpee Cups. That's apparently all you need to know. We got another email here. First off, Mayhem Nation. I must apologize. I'm not sure I can provide an email worthy of your 6th anniversary show, because after watching Raw, I have been funkified. Now, at first I was wondering what the hell was going on, then the jiggling of Big Brodus and his lovely ladies had me popping my hips and nodding my head. Popping his hips.
Now, don't try to master lock.
No, don't visualize. Now I'm so funkified, I can't sit still. Although the fact that Naomi from Tough Enough has a spot on WWE TV before M-Dog does make me sad. So Lunchbox says I don't listen to the show. LB, you complained during the holiday show when my voicemail talked about TNA. So why wouldn't I think you don't want me to talk about TNA? There's something else that will go along with the big freaky. Got to go. The Funkasaurus has me.
Wow. Have you tried masturbating?
That's a start. What else we got here, guys?
There's a Pierre Kelly in there somewhere.
Yes, there is.
I can take the Pierre Kelly.
Go for it.
To the WMS Nation. What in the name of Magnum TA did Daniel Bryan do to deserve this match? It was a title match for the Bug Gold Belt, and when D. Bryan went out of the ring, Sexual Chocolate Mark Henry shoved him down, meaning that it could be a rivalry in the making come next month. Who won by DQ? It was not Big Show, it was D. Bryan. He celebrated it, and the fans disliked it. Now, why do you think the man on top of the hill did something worse? Let me know what you think, Happy 6 WMS. PRK, a.k.a. Mr. Techwood Drive, sent for my iPod.
Thank you for reading that. Now,
I read the whole email.
I've had a theory.
Wow.
Over the last year, at least, that PRK and Big Freaky are the same person.
Oh, really?
Oh God.
Go ahead and take that exact same PRK email, and then put it in Big Freaky's voice and read it out loud.
Okay.
It's the same person.
I think.
What in the name of Magnum GA did Daniel Bryan do to deserve this mess? It was a title match for the big gold belt, and when D. Bryan went out of the ring, Sexual Chocolate Mark Henry shoved him down, meaning that it could be a rivalry in the making come next month.
Huh.
You're right. One by like DQ. Two sentences in, I zoned out. You're right. It's the same person.
It's the same person!
Speaking of which, we do have a voicemail from Big Freaky, and LB, I think you need to listen to this. A little more explanation from that email that we read before.
Oh, good.
Happy anniversary, all the what best and all that. But Lunchbox, just remember, you say I don't listen to the show, well, I remember at the end of the show last week, you were talking about how stupid and inept the writers are of WWE. Why are you watching a product written by people that you hold in such low esteem? That's a serious question, by the way.
Serious question.
Yeah. Serious question.
So, LB, what is your response to Big Freaky? Who was calling you out on the carpet.
No, I can answer this question for him.
This is for LB.
Hey, tag me in.
I can answer this for him.
Why is it? Calm it down. Everybody calm it down.
Ooh, tag it in.
Okay. Steam Machine?
Yeah.
Show him how it's done.
Well, he clearly watches it because he has a podcast about it.
I would just like to add to that he watches it. He watches it for the same reason that I watched Raw last night.
Okay.
Pure habit.
Yeah. Because we're wrestling fans and we watch wrestling and it's Raw. And we may shake our heads, but we enjoy it. LB, go ahead.
Listen, we're not, according to Big Freaky, we're not actually wrestling fans. Just because we watch Raw doesn't make us wrestling fans.
Then what are we?
We have to go to all the indie shows and watch all the Ring of Honor and buy all the DVDs to be wrestling fans.
At 1:30 in the morning.
Hey, hold on.
And that's a shoot. Lunchbox,
are you telling me that you don't own the entire High Spots DVD collection?
You know, AJ, it's a shameful secret, but I do not.
40 discs.
You know what? I'm going in my closet. I need to help you out here. I'll be back.
Oh my God. Where's it going?
Shit just got real.
Is that chicken in there? What is it there?
I don't know.
I don't have it either, so I'm not a wrestling fan.
Everybody's theory here was right. I do watch for the podcast. I do watch out of habits. I also watch because I genuinely enjoy professional wrestling, even when it's bad.
That's true. There you go.
Not every show is going to be great. You got to take the good with the bad.
Mm-hmm.
You take the good. You take the bad.
You take both.
The facts of life. your facial expression on that was priceless.
I can't take that one.
No?
Is there anything else?
According to Freaky, then, we need to change the title of the show. It's been 6 years.
Okay.
Riz is right. He's in the chat room.
Okay.
It's been 6 years. We need to change the title of the show. From now on, this is the SEMS, the Sports Entertainment Mayhem Show.
I don't want to talk about sports.
That's a good
point. We're not allowed to call it wrestling anymore because we don't watch enough amateur falling down.
We can just drop the W.
Right, we can just drop the W.
So we're just going to be the Mayhem Show?
Right.
EMS, we can be EMS.
No. We can just be WMS. And that's it. We can't refer to ourselves as the Wrestling Mayhem Show anymore. We're just WMS.
We're the podcast formerly known as the Wrestling Mayhem Show.
We could just be the Stuff Mayhem Show.
The Stuff Show? The popular culture mayhem show?
Stuff. Not even that far.
Stuff Mayhem.
Not popular culture. Well, yeah. Well, sorry. That's because that's PMS.
Shut the fuck up!
PMS.
Nice. He listens well.
Welcome to PMS.
He listens well.
PMS. If that's the name, we need to get a female on the show, Sorg.
Yeah.
We would have so many weird different listeners.
According
PMS show.
According to Bobby, if we change our name to the show formerly known as the Wrestling Mayhem Show, the symbol has to be an ampersand.
I can get behind that.
And with
yeah, I'm all right with that. Yeah, with the same it twists and turns like our minds.
Yes. There you go.
Is that the email?
I think that's all we have for the email here.
Is it time?
So we can get to the amateur falling down segment.
Is it time for the whack ass minute?
Right.
Whack ass minute of wrestling.
Week in amateur falling down. Let's go, Russell fan. What's going on?
This week in amateur falling down. Well, first of all, I'm going to mention something we mentioned on last week's show, which was that Evolve Wrestling will be hosting the last show ever for, I'm assuming however long, at the ECW Arena.
Don't worry about him. Just go on.
Okay.
Play through. Show must go on.
Okay. So, Gabe Sapolsky, who's the booker for Evolve and Dragon Gate and all that other stuff, announced on his Twitter, I believe last night actually, that Joey Styles will be at the Evolve show, the very last show in the ECW Arena. He will be there to sign autographs, to meet with the fans. You can get your pictures with him. It's going to be a very interesting event. Memorial of, you know, what was the ECW Arena. Main event of that show, the final match in the ECW Arena, will be friend of the show Johnny Gargano defending his newly won Dragon Gate USA title against Ricochet, which is definitely going to be a great match. So get your tickets at EvolveWrestling.com. Also, CZW is doing a show right before then, so get your tickets for CZW. And just if you're in that area, definitely you want to be there to celebrate, you know, what was the ECW Arena, basically. Next, I'm going to move into some local stuff on the Texas scene. Not really a rundown. River City Wrestling this past weekend had their event, New Year's Evolution 3. I heard it was amazing. I sadly could not attend, but I heard the event was absolutely amazing, which featured friend of the show Ray Rowe taking on TNA superstar Hernandez in a I Quit match, and what I heard was absolutely insane. A lot of crazy stuff going on. If you want to check them out, go to rivercitywrestling.net. They have photos up from the past event and just kind of recapping, you know, what was going on. And their next event will be, I believe, February 4th is the date, which will see the return of Alyssa Flash to River City Wrestling. So check that out. Get your tickets for that. And then also in the Texas area this weekend, I will be at an event for Anarchy Championship Wrestling in Austin, Texas. It will be Guilty by Association 6, which is going to be their 5th year anniversary show. It's a big show for them. So definitely go check them out. Some of the more higher profile matches on the card. It's going to be for the ACW Heavyweight title, ACH facing Gary J. Portia Perez will be going one-on-one with Robert Evans in a grudge match of epic proportions.
Don't worry about it.
Go. Squeak. Jerry Lynn will be there as a special guest to compete. A lot of great wrestling action. If you want to go check them out, go to anarchychampionshipwrestling.com. All the front row seats have been sold out. You can still get general admission, however. It's Sunday night, January 15th, 2012, in Austin, Texas. Go check them out and go support them. Hopefully, I will see you there. And also, the last thing I want to mention on the Indie Minute is a big thank you, or not thank you, but a big congratulations to a pretty close friend of the show, one David Ardemira, even though he murdered Doc Remedy. He is getting a title, his first title match of his career for the next IWC event, January 27th. He and Tyler Stone will face the One-Nighters for the IWC Tag Team Championships. So that's a big, big moment for David Ardemira. Go out, support him, check him out. I'm sure it's going to be a great match. And I thought that was going to be the end of the Indie Minute, but no, because Bobby F. J-Town just sent in the AON report.
Now I'm paying attention. I'm awake, you guys. I'm awake. Hold on.
I'll wait for AJ.
Hold on.
He's still talking.
Go.
Okay. Happy anniversary, guys. Only thing for the AON report is them moving to Saturday mornings at 1:30 a.m. on WATM 23 out of Altoona/Johnstown. Also, the AON report also the AON report, and then say that the next show is January 21st in Altoona for Necessary Hatred. And also, happy anniversary once again, WMS. Insert dubstep.
Oh, no, no, no.
Remix!
Thank you. Now let's toss it. That's all for the indie stuff. Let's toss it.
All right, it's now the end of this hour in indie wrestling.
Chachi, I will.
Hey, shut the fuck up.
Whoa. Let's toss it to a little preview of what's going on in WMS Gold if you guys got the app. And a little bit from one of our new partners here at Sorgatron Media. And we'll be right back with Remember When?
The memo.
No, you did. You just couldn't read it. I just threw my glasses on the floor.
Anything you want me to put under you, like a Twitter or anything?
No.
How come...
Spoilers, Sorg!
How come he gets WMS Original?
Because he hasn't been around. Because
you've been here for a year.
A real person.
A real female person.
She was a normal human being.
Who happens to work?
We don't expect those sorts of things on Google Hangouts.
Who ends up, happens to work. Hey everybody, welcome back, Wrestling Mayhem Show, and it's the time that we remember when... Now this week, we of course have our special guest joining us, Steam Machine, the esteemed Steam Machine.
I see what you did there.
Oh, so, why didn't we ever use that?
I don't know.
It's like you're trying to play with words.
So I mean, it's been a while. You kind of been out of the whole following wrestling game for a bit there, Steamer.
Steamer.
Oh, no, that's old. That one's old. That's...
Yeah, I know. Remember that one time you got hit by a tire? No, we're not playing that.
That was
game.
A road con, by the way.
So you were sitting here asking here, us on the break, who was still around, basically, because you had mentioned like John Cena and Triple H were going back and forth with the title for a bit. So let's play a game of who the fuck is still around. So it hit us.
Okay. Let's see here.
Wrong. Every time he puts me on the
side. Right. let's see here. Oh, what was his name? He had like the he was a heel. Okay, we're gonna play who is this wrestler? He was a heel and I got his name. Rob Conway.
Gone. Last I knew he was wrestling for like NWA Hollywood or something. No, he's gone.
He's been gone for a while. Had something for
Look at me.
She was like a friggin' Randy Newman song for an intro. I mean, that was can't beat that shit. Okay, what about Chris Masters?
Gone.
Came back. Gone again.
Okay. He didn't die of roid rage or anything.
No, called me a redneck at a local show once.
Oh,
no, now he makes his titties dance.
Yeah. Has anyone broken the master lock yet?
Soldier did at a tribute to troops.
Who the fuck is Soldier?
No.
Who the fuck is Soldier?
The greatest professional wrestler of all time, Sorg. Bobby frickin' Lashley broke the master lock, okay?
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Bobby Lashley.
You know what I just remembered? I remembered whenever I kept saying that they should call him Bobby Lash. That's a much better name. I still agree with that. And I remember that because whenever you said Bobby Lashley, I said, Bobby Lash is a much better name.
Well, guess what? He's gone, too.
He's gone?
Yeah.
Good. That's pretty good.
Went to TNA, MMA. Gone again.
MMA.
See, Lashley kind of just reminded me of a rehash of Goldberg. And I'm not going to apologize for that. I love Goldberg. I still love Goldberg.
He's gone, too.
Well, I imagine. Isn't he doing announcing for... UFC?
That's Mike Goldberg.
Well, I thought he did.
No relation.
Well, how do you know? I'm looking at the picture. No, that's how do you know?
You're probably right. I don't
know. You're looking at the picture box.
Related.
Yeah, I'm looking at the picture box where the words are coming from. okay. Now, he was gone. He was gone whenever I was watching, but did DDP come back or is he dead?
No, he's been doing real yoga for real men.
Yeah, he does yoga now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
See, yeah.
Honestly, like, he's a... never mind.
I want to know what you...
DDP, you want to know my thing? My DDP feelings are very deep, first off. He was an amazing face. And then they decided to turn him into a heel, and then, like, his personality bled over because he's a fucking asshole. And so then he couldn't stop being an asshole. I honestly, it was like, whenever he was a face, I liked him. Oh, there we go.
Yoga for regular guys.
I don't know if DDP, who, you know, regularly gives himself a self high five, is a regular guy. I don't...
To his penis.
Yeah. Penis five. What?
Although, interesting, I googled it. I suppose this is the recent social changes, but friend of the show, Chris Brogan, apparently does yoga for regular guys.
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Good. He can't even keep that job. All right. Let's see here. What about Sting? I know he was in TNA whenever...
Still in TNA
he's
now.
He's still in TNA, and now he's himself / Joker?
Well, no, not anymore.
No, that was for a little bit.
So now who is he? Is he now, back
now
in
he, now, he, now he's like the general manager sort of figure.
Yeah. What about Kurt Angle? Is he still like raping dudes?
Yep. Yep.
And raping men. Yeah. Yes.
Jeff Jarrett?
Still there.
Yes.
Still around there.
Oh, Jarrett actually stole and married Kurt Angle's wife.
Like in real life.
Legitimately, in real life.
In real life, yeah.
Well, again, Kurt Angle's an asshole. What does he expect? okay. What about... what was the flippy dude in TNA? AJ Styles.
The whole X Division. Nope, they're gone.
AJ Styles? He's still around.
Did he break anything yet?
A couple of times.
I was honestly waiting for him to flip around, just land square on his head, dead. And of course, TNA just record the whole thing, you know. You know, we have the highest ratings ever.
Yeah,
they could only hope for some ratings generating bullshit like that.
Maybe they should just never mind. honestly, I think maybe what they should do is they should actually try and jump ship to like a Showtime or something where they can just show nudity or something. Just go with that route.
Go with the TNA name, you know? Right. They used to have like strippers dancing at ringside, but they took that away.
Midgets jerking off in trash cans.
Yeah.
I think that would be a good match. Jerk off in a trash can, and then the loser... You lose whenever you get put in the trash can.
Ew.
Full of midgets. I like it.
Yeah. Yeah. Losers get
you know who'd be good for a match like that? Jimmy DeMarco.
I think what they should do is just let everyone in the audience jerk off in the trash can.
Hey, they're getting...
Buy a ticket and get a free trash can.
And if you're in the front row, one of the hot girls will do it for you.
Splash zone.
Jizz can on a pole match.
There you go. You could even suspend the trash can
from the rope X.
Yeah, from the rope X. And then you have to go up there and get it down.
Destination Jizz can.
You have to get it down from the rope X without spilling any of the jizz.
Yeah, Wrestling Mayhem that's... Show 303 Destination Jizz Can.
You're just like this. There's just some guy going, no, no.
It's like slime time.
Splashed in the face of a bunch of jizz.
Oh, you said the magic word, and it splashes on top of you.
Or what they could do is they could do like that Japanese shit and have the landmines under the ring, except for have those filled with jizz.
Oh,
Yeah,
we missed you. It would be like a first blood match. But legit,
if it's the first blood match, you need to see a doctor.
No, first person that gets jizz on them loses.
Yeah, no.
It's, yeah, actually, I think isn't all the pornography first facial like out. A first jizz match?
First facial out. That's yes. It.
Oh, man.
Wow.
Oh, God.
Honestly, I'm just waiting for the day whenever we just push it back, go full circle back to Roman style, and we just start having wrestlers just pull them out of prison. Just wrestle them to death. It'll be fine. It'll be great.
I think they that Velvet Sky on a pole match.
Yeah, there you go.
Or, that's yeah. Called backstage at a TNA event. Yes.
No. If the Steam Machine hasn't been, seeing them as much, I think TNA has moved. Like, because you know how they're in the era where it's like all pole matches and stuff like that? They've moved from pole matches to matches with shark cages.
They've always kind of had shark cages, though, right? I mean,
I know, but they're doing them a lot. But shark
now. Would have a job.
I've never seen a man wrestle a shark.
There you go.
Bukkake Mania 26 or a Velvet Sky on everyone's pole match.
Oh, Matt Mike and Riz in the chat there.
Instead of
Matt Carlins, I just logged on. I can't believe what I'm hearing.
Instead of an I quit match, we
six
could have
6 years, motherfucker. 6 years.
We could have an I shit match.
I don't know what's going on anymore.
Yeah, you literally make everyone eat like one of those $5 big boxes at Taco Bell. And then you throw each other around. The first person to shit themselves loses.
You know what? You know who's obviously winning that match? Blue Meanie.
He'll come out. Is he back?
No, he is.
First off, let me clear this up for Matt.
Okay.
We're talking about...
It started with what wrestlers are still in WWE.
Yeah. It started with what wrestlers are still in WWE, and then it moved to what wrestlers are still wrestling, and now we're trying to guess where TNA is going to go to increase ratings.
Mad Mike says 2 out of 3 shits match.
I like that one.
You have to... No. What you have to do is you actually have to eat the entire, like, Pizza Hut magic box thing that they have.
It's got
pizza and just, breadsticks and all kinds of other dinner in a box.
Yeah,
you feed that entire thing and then wrestle a Destination X match. Good luck.
Ooh, I have another when question. What did we think whenever Brock Lesnar came out with the sword on his chest?
The penis tattoo.
Yeah.
It looks like a penis.
It looks like a penis tattoo.
That honestly was probably the dumbest tattoo I've ever seen. Like, if you're going to just go with a sword, maybe put it like a diagonal, or maybe get two, or maybe just a dragon. That would probably work the best. Yeah. Because he went UFC.
Yeah.
Came back to wrestling.
Well, now he just retired. Supposedly, he's coming back. There's speculation.
I thought he came back to WWE, then went back to UFC.
No, he
came back for a game.
He came back in a video game.
Yeah, he had kind of a face off with Undertaker at ringside at a UFC event.
Oh, did I tell
you
that
everybody jizzed over that?
Yes.
Was it good?
By the way, there's like talk on the Twitterverse or something like that. This guy said if Brock Lesnar does come back, and this guy's Goldberg says he wants to have, he would return to have a match with him. This is just the whole wrestling community. Don't.
No.
Well, see, the problem is now Goldberg has to be pushing 50. I mean, at 40, 50. I mean, he's no longer.
He's no worse off than like a Hulk Hogan or Ric Flair.
Well, yeah, but he can't hold up against a Brock Lesnar that's twice his size.
He couldn't hold up against him at WrestleMania 20 when they were booed out of the building.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was a bit of a problem.
Well, I'll tell you.
Right, so what makes them think that coming back to do the match again in any way, shape, or form is a good idea?
Because we didn't.
Hey.
We were watching it at home and still booing.
Mm-hmm. So. I still want to see the 90s match that absolutely everyone who cared about hating the other faction, WWF versus WCW, I want to see the Goldberg versus the Stone Cold Steve Austin that everyone talked about and compared them because they were both bald.
Yeah.
And goatees.
Right. They had goatees and they were bald. So have Mr. Clean grow a goatee. Throw him in the three-way. There you go. Of course, I heard he cheats and throws bleach into people's eyes.
On that note, and that is your Remember When...
Really, you're gonna close out that segment?
We got to because I'm.
There's a lot to talk about.
There's a lot going on, including let's toss it to Mad Mike's Minutes of Mayhem. Raise motherfucker, raise hell outside.
Get these fire about the force starting. Hey, Wrestling Mayhem Show. It's Mad Mike here once again with another Minute of Mayhem. Okay, first of all, I know. Everyone's talking a lot about Raw and everything, but for those of you who didn't watch SmackDown, Daniel Bryan had the greatest finish in a match I've ever seen. I know they replayed it on Raw, but it like, first of all, the match with the Big Show was really quite good. Bryan and Big Show worked amazingly well together, better than I thought they would. But the finish was just so fantastic. With Bryan, you know, goading Mark Henry into pushing him. And just this slight push causes a disqualification. I can't wait to see what they do on Friday for SmackDown. And I usually don't look forward to SmackDown, but with this Bryan character is kind of awesome. And if you don't watch SmackDown, you really should be. There was one thing I liked on Raw last night, one thing I didn't. Jericho. I understand, you know, I get the gimmick that he's doing. He wants to try and turn everyone against him. I mean, it seems like that's kind of what he's doing. But see, at least me personally, I don't know if he can get away with another week of doing this. Because it's not going to make me hate him. Because it's Jericho. I can't hate him. It's just going to make me bored. And I don't think that's what... I don't think that's the reaction they want to get. Granted, I know I'm the minority and most people are probably just going to start hating him, but... if he tries this shit again next week and just comes out and, you know, either, you know, is really happy or is verklempt or whatever, it's just going to get kind of boring for me, honestly. I mean, I was even tuning out during it last night. Next week, I don't think, he's probably not going to speak again, but I don't think I'll care nearly as much about it next week. Now... the last thing from Raw, which was amazing, is the Jive Soul Brodus himself. Brodus Clay re-debuting was magical. It's kind of a mix of Akeem and Ernest the Cat Miller, which separately pretty awful. Together, apparently pretty hilarious. So I think that's pretty much it for this week's Man of Mayhem. I just want to congratulate the Mayhem Show. I wish I could be there with you guys. I really do. I was there for the 5-year anniversary last year, and that was amazing. And 6 years, you know, fucking nuts. Sorg, LB, Chachi, our special guest, who I'm pretty sure I know who it is, and I know me saying it wouldn't spoil it, but, you know, congratulations to you as well, sir. Yeah, just, you know, let's have 6 more years of mayhem. Take care. Spike your hair, bitches.
Carlin's in the chat room says, I say we have Minute of Mayhem fire, and Indie Minute running split screen, and Chachi decides which one lives or dies.
I don't know, Chachi, what do you think?
You realize that if we were to do that, I would need you to pre-record your minute of indie, because it would go strictly based on length of video.
That's true.
Whoever records the shortest video wins that week.
That was definitely a lengthy one. Mike had a lot on his mind this week. But thank you for that. Brodus Clay, we talked about it a little bit on the in the fan mail, but and I made a comment last night on a few of the Twitters and such. If WWE is doing a lot of its booking based on the responses on Twitter, like Brodus Clay being trending for the past month, basically, and this is what we get. Zack Ryder is a perfect example. Where are we going from here? Does that mean at this point?
also, Alicia Fox, who seems to trend every week for no reason at all.
I guess the guys digged Alicia Fox. I mean, she's, you know,
pretty.
A girl?
She's a girl. She has boobs.
I mean, what else?
She has boobs.
Jinder Mahal.
Wait, Jinder Mahal? Yeah, Jinder Mahal's been trending, and now we see him on every show in the last couple of weeks. WWE, I mean, is this them listening to the crowd in a brand new way?
Unfortunately?
Yes. Why unfortunately?
And I think that
I don't like Jinder Mahal.
The general rule still reigns here that a crowd of people is generally the dumbest thing you could talk to. Now and again, a squirrel gets a nut, and that was Zack Ryder.
I don't want to
see Jinder Mahal.
So we're going to see a lot of...
damn about Brodus. Well, I kind of care about Brodus Clay.
So we're going to see a lot of Jinder Mahals and Brodus Clays that fall on their face, hypothetically, based on this whole Twitter push thing that's going on, thanks to Zack Ryder starting it. So is Zack Ryder like the NWO of this era, that he started the trend, now everybody's going to try to follow it, and it's going to become diluted?
No, yeah. Zack Ryder is just good at it.
Mm-hmm. Well, no, this is what happened. Zack Ryder actually built a character. Zack Ryder had people in the crowd that were expecting him to come out with a character that he had built through his YouTube show. Mm-hmm. And he wasn't just some random name being chanted in the crowd because people knew that he was on the roster and they wanted to see him. Nobody's chanting, "Where's Kurt Hawkins?"
Yeah.
Nobody's chanting for Yoshitatsu. Everybody's chanting for Zack Ryder.
Can I just say for a second that Yoshitatsu's Twitter feed is the funniest thing I've seen in my life?
I need to check that out.
At first, he was saying that all of his workouts were Super Saiyan workouts, and somehow now they're all Pokemon workouts.
Yeah. Like, he goes to the Pokemon gym and does battles for his workout. Mm-hmm.
That works out.
I mean,
it works.
You want to talk about people following the whole Zack Ryder shadow, like Booker or that Sorg was talking about, look at how many wrestlers now have their internet shows.
Mm-hmm.
It has grown. Mm-hmm. Like, was it Chris Masters? Tommy Dreamer.
Dreamer, yeah.
I think, like, Kurt Hawkins, like you mentioned, he has an animated series on YouTube where it's him and, like, Tyler Rex and all these random jobbers.
And you're
going to
see a lot of these are crap. I watched the Tommy Dreamer one, and it wasn't anything as a wrestling fan I gave a crap to watch, you know? It seemed like he was trying to be Zack Ryder / family videos, you know? It was really kind of weird. Versus, and I think the difference between Zack Ryder is, WWE always says, you know, you make your own opportunities and everything. If you're developing your character from week to week, but you're seeing it on the internet show, which is Superstars, which nobody gets to see, the fans won't get behind you because who sees that other than the live crowd? Let's be honest. How many people are watching that show? For people to get behind somebody, Big Freak. Okay. But then you get him. He's able to develop a character on a platform that has the opportunity to reach all of these fans that nobody else has a chance to. I think he's probably getting more views on his YouTube channel than Superstars is getting anywhere.
Yeah, Matt Carlin mentions the DiBiase posse. I know he's doing something with that. But, like, maybe it's because I don't want SmackDown all that much. I don't give a fuck about Ted DiBiase.
Even watching SmackDown, you have no idea what this DiBiase... You're like, oh, he does this. And I heard DiBiase did a New Year's party back home in Memphis and invited everybody for free.
Like, oh, great. It's like, you know, like...
All right. So they're creating this backstory. I don't see anything of this.
So he's a less drugged up version of the Hardy Boys. Great.
DiBiase posse getting some bitches.
All right.
Oh, wait. He has a channel on YouTube. I haven't checked this out. What do you got there, Steam?
Okay, so let's back this up for me a little bit. Okay, so now WWE is kind of trying the Twitter trending thing.
Like, mm-hmm. Yes.
Oh, they're full-blown
Twitter trending. Why hasn't, like, I'm surprised, like, 4chan or something hasn't gotten their hands on this and decided to run full tilt and be like, we want Ric Flair back. Get him in the ring. Get him another championship. You know, where's that?
Yeah, I think there's a lot
TNA.
There's a lot of opportunity for this to get gained, too, I think. Because, I mean, you know, who are the people on Twitter responding to, holy crap, Brodus Clay?
Well, again,
who are those people? Are those jackass smarks that they've been trying to avoid all these years? Finally, yep. Have a direct line in the WWE?
Yeah.
Well, and WWE's listening to them.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
That's like, again, the last time someone outside of wrestling, so sorry, guys. Like last year with the Madden game that everyone liked so much, they did the online poll of who should be on the cover, and they picked some jackass from the Browns. And everyone's like,
yeah.
What? And so I'm waiting for that to happen with wrestling. Like, oh, bring back Matt Stryker, you know?
Fuck yes, bring back Matt Stryker.
Did he ever actually have a match?
Riz says, wait, WWE's listening? I know they're listening because Ricardo said fucking remix in the middle of his bit last night.
All right.
Something that I had said 6 hours earlier.
Fine. Mm-hmm. Since Matt Stryker's still around somewhere.
Yep,
Laparca. Laparca.
You have to say it on Twitter.
Oh, I have to say it?
Yeah.
Okay.
You have to get on Twitter and say it. That's the only way they're listening to you.
I'm going to lean, and you put Twitter under me.
What the hell? Can he sit on your iPad?
What?
Can he sit on your iPad?
The quickest way to get on Twitter.
Yeah, right.
Just sit on it.
Yeah. Do you need a lesson in Twitter?
Yeah, just twit and spin.
Oh, Mike has a brilliant idea.
What's that?
Yoshi and Santino need a team.
And take down a giant lizard creature.
That'd be amazing.
Honestly, that would probably work, too.
I would sell tickets.
Yeah, yeah.
That brings it in. That brings in the bucks. Fucking Yoshitatsu.
Is that you or me?
I don't know. I haven't figured it out where it's coming from. I don't think it's in our system.
Okay.
But I just don't know. Sorry, we're having cell phone issues over here, apparently. What else is going on? What are we talking about here?
If we want to talk about, there was a pay-per-view this weekend.
No, we're not on that yet.
No, we should get on the pay-per-view. What was it?
So Daniel Bryan has been interesting lately. I don't know. What do you guys
think? Not interesting enough.
What?
Not interesting enough.
Why not, LB?
Yeah.
LB?
What? Oh, no. I was commenting on the... You said Daniel Bryan's been interesting, and then everyone was silent. not interesting Cricket. Enough.
No. All right.
No, it's a big trend now to predict, oh, he's going to turn heel. It's going to be... They're going to turn him heel.
Well,
oh, John Cena's going to be a heel, and Daniel Bryan is going to be a heel, and this is heel activity. Is it? Oh, really?
I'll tell you what. If they turn Cena heel... You might as well just kill his career. Kill his career right then and there.
Thank you.
Oh, absolutely.
You.
Because he has no personality.
I don't know about that.
No. Unless they've given him personality in the last 5 years, he has no personality. His personality is being a face.
Mm-hmm.
And as soon as you just make him an asshole, everyone's going to go, oh, I don't even... It's not that I hate him. It's that I don't give a shit about him. Because the reason why people like him as a face is because, oh, all these new guys come in and they're going to fucking gang rape him. But he's going to persevere. No, there was the Young Bloods or the New Bloods or these, everyone yeah, wearing.
The old ECW one.
My thing
whatever.
Is, yeah, my NXT. Thing is, if people want John Cena to be fresh, and they're like, oh, we have to turn him heel because he's not fresh anymore. You know what will make John Cena fresh? Giving him new people to work with.
Yeah. I mean,
honestly.
I mean, remember when he was tearing down the house doing matches with Shawn Michaels for a half an hour?
Remember this stuff that I haven't been in. Last time I was interested in John Cena, this is the CM Punk thing.
Yeah.
I was going to say, that's CM Punk. Him, those two put off a great match together.
Yeah, and they say, and people are saying, oh, If they turn Cena heel, he'll have new people to face. Really? He'll have...
Not really, no, because it'll be the ones that were heel against him. So.
Yeah, true.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Honestly, I don't mind the face-v-face matchup.
No.
Now, granted, most of the time it does end up in a heel turn, but... Oh, well, who gives a shit?
It's easier to do face-v-face than heel-v-heel.
Mm-hmm.
Because, oh, I mean, they haven't had that. Everyone's just like, fuck them.
No, you need to... Oh, see, that's the thing is, since, you know, the late, great Macho Man, there hasn't really been a heel that you cheer for. I mean, of course you've had your Gold Dusts and your...
Orton. Orton's that's kind of happening with
fuck
now.
Orton. Orton is so... Oh, God, I hate... Like, see, that's the thing is, like, I hate him to the point that I don't want to watch him. Like, I just...
Really?
Really. Like, it really makes me want to get married just so I can beat my wife. I mean, like...
Wow.
I just... there's only one thing that man does well that I actually watch him for is that he can pull an RKO out of his ass. He could literally be facing the other way, and he will literally pop out of his own ass to RKO someone.
he's kept on the same level as Cena. The only difference is he's been having a tendency as of late to put out some great matches with guys like Wade Barrett, guys like Christian. You know, he kind of is that workhorse in a way.
Well, again, I've never taken away his work ethic. The guy's still just I don't know, like. I guess he has the face thing down so well that I just want to, like, smack him and run away. Of course, he'd probably pop out of a shadow in RKO.
Yeah, he'll pop out of his ass in RKO.
Wet pace.
Yeah, exactly.
He has no draw other than that I can hit an RKO out of anywhere. I can work and put out really good matches, and I can be a generally cocky guy.
But
he really didn't have any... He hasn't really changed a promo style. He hasn't given me anything saying, like, yes, this guy is somebody I want to watch week in and week out, and even when he doesn't wrestle and he only has a promo, I'm going to watch that 5 to 10 minute segment.
It's for the ladies.
No, I don't want to watch that. If Randy Orton starts talking, I'm fast forwarding because I only watch his crap on DVR. Yeah.
Well, no, that Sorg's right. The ladies go fucking crazy for it.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, did
same the way they go for Cena. I mean, you know, it's just part of the, you know.
Did they get past the he's crazy thing?
Which one?
Sort of.
Where he hears voices?
Other than his theme music.
Oh, well.
He still has the theme music, but okay. He kind of really isn't doing anymore.
Here's a question that I'd like to hear your guys' response, since we were just talking about Cena doing a heel turn. What would Orton as a face be like?
Orton, pretty much.
Ooh, unsuccessful. Right, I think they did that a while back.
Orton?
Because they're doing it now.
He's kind of a face now.
Yeah, no, Orton.
Kind of a face.
Orton is doing the kind of, he's a face like a Stone Cold.
He's a gray area
thing.
Oh,
yeah,
don't compare the two.
No, he is.
Don't compare the two.
But that's what they're doing.
Because he doesn't give a shit, and he'll take out anybody.
No, he's.
But people are cheering him, so they're putting him against the heels.
See, that's another thing. Well, I'll go with what AJ said. The crowd, the audience, are literally a giant, massive retard that just needs to be beaten and lit on fire.
Oh, let's talk about the retards again.
Wait,
what it comes down to. They're going to cheer for things that the WWE wants them to cheer for. If they start cheering things, the WWE, and honestly, Vincent Kennedy McMahon, is going to hear the cheers for certain people and say, all right, these people like this guy, let's make him a face and put him into a bunch of heel, let's have him start wrestling heels. This happened with Santino. This is the exact same thing that happened with Santino. People didn't like Santino for the longest time. And then all of a sudden, he started just being generally kind of goofy, started doing funny things, but he was doing them from a heel point of view, and then people started cheering, and everybody went, I kind of like this. It's goofy. It's dumb. It's not something that I'm used to. And then they started cheering him. And then Santino got a shirt. And then Santino got merch. And then Santino started being cheered. And, like, Santino comes out. You hear Santino's music. People cheer. They stand up and they cheer. Because they want to see him do that goofy-ass Cobra move and win improbable matches. That's it. It's all Santino does.
You know who they need to bring back? Boogeyman.
Oh, shit. No, they couldn't. Well, here's the problem. He was getting, like, he is starting to have actual medical problems from eating worms.
Well, you know, that's not my problem. that's a Boogeyman problem, not a my problem.
That's not a Steam Machine problem.
Yeah, that's not a Steam problem. Sorry,
you pulled up Randy Orton's Twitter account. So he's out with an injury from being thrown down a flight of stairs.
Oh, please.
And then, like, 2 days later, he's tweeting, "Hey, my Xbox won't connect to my wireless network. Can somebody help me?" Like, Randy Orton needs tech support, apparently.
I gotta play this game with my face on it.
See, look,
I'm trying to play a game where I wave my hand and Netflix starts playing. That's what I want to do right now.
And, you know, in all honesty, he doesn't need to eat real fucking worms. He can just use gummy worms, for Christ's sake. Jesus Christ.
Oh, he does that shit.
Well, that's just
he's also regarded as a terrible, terrible wrestler.
You put him in his mouth, chewed a couple, and then just spit him out.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
But again, you know, as far as him being a terrible wrestler, have we actually watched Triple H wrestle at all?
It's basically stumbling around. This is why I hate The Undertaker, because it's just stumbling at this point.
What the hell is that?
It's the Boogie Woogie Man.
Oh, they need to bring him back.
Oh my God, that beard is Mike Knoxworthy. What's it, the Boogie Man?
Wide open, open, wide open. I think we found Techno Viking's dad.
That is amazing. By the way, someone, we want to talk about Triple H wrestling. Someone needs to show Steam Machine the Triple H Kevin Nash ladder match.
Oh yeah, so Kevin Nash came back.
Give me the match of the year 2011.
Did he get Scott Hall clean for an hour?
No.
Oh. Nope.
Nope. So he came back.
Yeah.
And someone in the writer's room decided it'd be a great idea to have Kevin Nash versus Triple H.
Yeah.
In a ladder match with a sledgehammer hanging from the center of the ring.
So he can hold the top of it while he hits someone with it.
Well, yes.
Yeah.
But that's, you're focusing on the wrong part.
Oh, okay. So basically it's high boot versus knee.
In a ladder match.
Yeah, in a ladder match.
Which one of them can barely walk as it is.
Did someone give Kevin Nash a taser? Because that's the only way that fucker can win.
No taser.
Listen, old wrestlers, just stop. Just stop.
Yeah.
Kevin Nash, you're done. You were done in 01, in middle of the NWO run. You were done. Yeah. Triple H, hang him up. I know that people get excited when they hear Motorhead. I think that's just because they like Lemmy. Just stop. Let the young guys have their time. You wasted 10 minutes of my life with the sledgehammer on a ladder pole, whatever the hell that was, match, which was nothing more than one guy getting to use a weapon in that match that they couldn't already use. Because in said match, they used a chair, a ladder, a table, some other things around the ringside, various other foreign objects. But the point of the match was to get the sledgehammer, because apparently that's the only way you can win this match. No, you beat each other within an inch of each other's lives because you're 50 and it's shameful.
Yeah, there is a point where it gets to be embarrassing.
Just stop.
50 and shameful.
Kane, I'm sorry, this new Kane
also
thing.
Also a good title for the show.
Also a good title. What's his name? What's the one you don't like, Chachi?
What?
Chachi. What's his name?
Scott Baio.
Scott Baio. Scott Baio is 50 and shameful.
That doesn't make sense.
I mean, honestly, it's gotten to the point now where they just have these guys who come out just to take up time. And it's just terrible. That they could have invested that storyline with Kevin Nash. Fuck you, Kevin Nash. You could have literally just taken that entire storyline and given it to the mid-card run of a Cody Rhodes match. You could have given that time to bringing up another undercard match. You instead of Triple H and Kevin Nash being old and stumbling around a 20-foot wrestling ring for a sledgehammer on a thing that they shouldn't be climbing on. This goes for Kevin Nash. This goes for Scott Steiner. This goes for half of the TNA roster because they're all old WWE guys. Just stop. Just hang it up. Let it go. Maybe you can get some extra money wrestling for like someplace in Japan where I don't have to watch you or even hear about you even wrestling. And I can go, oh, Kevin Nash is still wrestling. How about that shit? But it's in like Puerto Rico where I don't have to see you.
Hey, AJ, Mad Mike makes a good point. Scott Steiner is the most over guy in TNA.
Yeah.
Which is why nobody watches TNA. People go, holy crap, Scott Steiner, it's 97 again. Holy crap, he's going to do the Scott Steiner is going to die in a ring.
Speaking of having the wrong segment of wrestling crowd to listen to, there's that TNA situation down there in Orlando, which has never gotten fixed. But yeah. So other than that, Raw was a reenactment of the hit movie Wrong Turn last night.
Yes, because the entire episode was in fact a wrong turn.
Let's talk about that. Let's talk.
Well last night kind of had that like 80s/90s feel.
It did.
And it was nice. I liked it. It was entertaining. But they still need a little bit more work.
Mm-hmm. Yep. It started off the same way it ended. And that was with WWE pretending that it's still in the Attitude Era.
There's definitely kind of
a
rollback to that.
What do you mean, really?
Because what do you like? You mean with the Kane thing?
Yes.
Yeah.
I don't see how that's outside. Fighting in a ring.
Yeah. The whole
The whole battling in the backstage area to the loading dock and beating the crap out of someone with a pile of cardboard boxes is complete Attitude Era.
Just the idea that the fact that we had a tire changing scene, the very right. long oh out of ring segment storyline thing
talk about that.
Is. I mean, you know, you were a fetus when the Attitude Era was. I understand that, WrestleFan. But this is the kind of feeling we recall from the Attitude Era. Just without
The WCW era.
Let's talk about that getaway scene. Let's talk about it. For those that don't know, last night Raw was actually in Corpus Christi, which I'm at right now.
By the way, thank you, WrestleFan. During the hangout last night, he was giving us a geographical layout of like why does he just go across the street to the Omni?
Because every time they're in Corpus Christi for a show, somebody goes in the river.
Yeah.
Somebody goes in the river. I don't care who it is. Someone, and they did the whole thing in the beginning where Cena and Kane are fighting and they go to the outside. And I'm like, no, because the river is on the other side of the arena. Completely other side of the arena. Second of all, Zack Ryder and Eve are on the run from Kane. And he goes out, he puts Eve in the car, and he sees there's a flat tire. He takes 20 minutes. 20 minutes to change a flat tire.
Have you ever changed a flat tire?
Yeah, have you ever changed a flat tire before? It actually takes a great deal of time.
That's fine.
Yeah, he actually changed that shit pretty quick.
Yeah.
That's fine. My thing is, I've been in that arena before. From where they were at, they could have been at the fucking other side of the city by now. But no, they're just changing this tire because, you know.
Well, you can't drive anywhere on a flat tire, jackass.
Listen, the worst thing was changing the tire before jacking it up.
Yeah, let's talk about that.
Wait, hold on. Go ahead, AJ.
I was going to save this for my what I learned from wrestling this week, but you know what? I'm going to burn it right now. Zack Ryder, Jack goes under the car before you start loosening bolts, or else you're going to end up with a car on top of your dumb ass. I'm just saying this from a safety perspective, Zack Ryder. I want you to continue making YouTube shows. Put the jack under the car with your dumb girl inside of it.
But no, like, he could have been in the fucking Omni Hotel by then, you know, having champagne or whatever.
Not with a flat tire!
Walking!
I know, walking! Walking!
Oh yeah, let's hang out right across the street. That makes perfect sense in the getaway scheme.
The only way they would have done that scene is if it's Zack Ryder and Eve Torres like running from the arena, and then there's just Kane walking behind him with music in the background going. That's the only way that scene would have worked.
I'm sorry,
that wouldn't have worked anyways because there was no black people dying in him. Scene.
Whoa, man.
Oh, come on. That would have been a good time for sexual chocolate to take a dive.
JTG has been dead to me for a very long time.
Mark Henry, JTG, R-Truth, just being thrown off of buildings, landing on cars, and that's a quiet moment. It's,
And here comes the hate mail.
See, okay. Yeah. Listen, this is one of the reasons why I can't watch Raw anymore. I mean, it's... Well, I'll tell you, the main reason why I stopped watching Raw is because I actually watched a couple DVDs of the best of Shakara.
Mm-hmm.
Have you guys seen Shakara?
Yes, yeah, so I've been to King of Trios last year. Oh,
it's so... It honestly is the... It's the essence of wrestling.
Mm-hmm.
It is a bunch of guys... truly enjoying wrestling. They have these shit storylines. They have these shit gimmicks. Like, I'll tell you what, my favorite...
You call it shit gimmicks? They're the greatest.
No.
Ants.
They are the greatest. Like, they're so shitty, they're amazing. Like, the Los Ice Cream Brothers?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
No, Steve, have you seen the marching band gimmick?
I haven't seen the marching band gimmick.
Oh, you have to look that up.
Oh,
my
God. I've
seen the one that are like classic sports people. Like, there's Dunk
Hooper. Dasher Hatfield and Sugar Dunkerton.
Yeah, Sugar Dunkerton. And just like, they end up playing a game of basketball in the middle of the match. It's fantastic.
Well, I'll tell you what. I fell in love with Shakara the moment the Los Ice Cream Brothers brought out a bag, and the announcer's like, "No, it can't be!" And they dump out a bag of sprinkles on the on everything, and they're like, "Not the sprinkles! No!" And then what made it 10 times better, whenever they powerbombed a dude into the sprinkles, he acted like he was on fire. Just amazing.
The best I ever saw was at the ants, the colony of the ants.
Oh, I love the ants.
In a match. A big tag match, and there was a grenade, an invisible grenade, and everybody it went into slow motion, and the one guy sacrificed himself on the grenade for everybody else.
See,
the first match we saw at King of Trios had a slow motion spotted. That's the greatest.
Nope, I gotta say this one, Osirian Portal.
The dancing, the dance-offs are great. I mean,
that one made ESPN.
It did.
But see, it's like you go and watch Shakara, where you see all these people who truly have a passion for it, and it's not that they have no interest in. Well, I'm sure some of them have an interest in fame, but that's not the driving factor, you know.
Yeah.
But then you go and switch over to WWE, where it's like people that can loosely using the term can wrestle, but have a passion to be pro wrestlers.
Yeah. I think Shakara is a very good example of a company with a definite and different vision. But you get that with a lot of these indie shows, whether it be like IWC or PWO, you get these guys that like are into it and are there because they want to be there. You know,
and
not trying to adapt to this TV style,
right?
You know, and you get to see something different like Shakara, or you get to see something different like a Jason Gorey or Michael Fassad that you're not going to see on TV,
right?
You know,
yeah.
And that's
or an Andromeda or a Honky Kong,
or a banana. Wait, what was that? Was it a banana on a pole? On a
banana? No, banana ladder match.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, this is what he saw last month. You know, I mean, WrestleFan goes.
It's to a man shows. Who thinks he's a monkey.
Yes, WrestleFan goes to indie shows down there in Texas that makes him question his sexuality.
Well, again, if you have a man as a monkey, yep. I mean. Is it homosexuality or is it bestiality? I mean, tend to not cross over. I think it's both on him. But, like, you know what? That actually brings up another, the banana ladder match. You know, I think that would be another good match.
Hmm.
Fucking KY ladder match. Yeah. You fucking lube the shit out of a ladder. You can put whatever you want on top. I think what you should do, that would be it. That's it. Lube up a ladder. Okay?
Step one.
Right. And I'm not Step talking one. About, like, the steps. I'm talking the rungs. Okay? And at the top is an expensive vase, and you can't break it.
Why are you not booking
it.
A fan?
I love it.
Well, I keep applying, but they keep saying no. That's
that's when you just sign up and do your own thing.
Well, I also, I've always been a fan of the idea of the room full of chairs match, where you just go into a back room and it's just literally a catacomb of folding chairs.
Well, there's a guy like this. I think you'd be interested. Bobby said to bring him up over in Johnstown. There's a Seowen that we mentioned earlier, and there's this guy Manchild that wears a mask pretty much like this.
That's pretty cool. I can dig that.
I guess when he gets mad, he puts on a sad face.
I think I've heard of him.
There is a piece that's on the mask.
Okay,
that he like rips off, and when he rips it off, it goes from a big smile to like an angry face, and then he just whips everybody's ass. That's how it works. That's Manchild's gimmick. He works at a Subway.
That's amazing.
Oh, he works in a Subway. So we love Johnstown and AON Wrestling because it's like that. It's like it's Chikara level. They've had 3 murders, 6 kidnappings.
And this is why we talk about them on the show. We talk to the promoter for it. They're tremendous.
Oh, that's amazing.
We haven't seen very much except for a few YouTube clips, but it's they have won in our hearts because of the stuff we hear about.
Well,
yeah, it's just like this guy got murdered. You're like,
yeah.
Wait, what?
Kidnappings? Yeah.
Now does he get murdered like as a for a match or is it just a random murder?
There's like it was like terrorism or some stuff like that. Like it's just like a series of murders happening.
House got blown up.
The cartel was trying to take over. I think that's what it was. I'm pretty sure the cartel was taking over. So they were kidnapping and murdering and blowing shit up.
I think now there's a male pregnancy in there or something.
Male pregnancy.
Okay, that's nice.
What?
See, that's real wrestling. Not none of this. Let's baby our wrestlers to WrestleMania and then have them actually show, hey, I'm actually a real wrestler bullshit like I do every fucking year.
Yeah.
Hey, do you guys remember back in, I guess probably WrestleMania 25 or so, whenever they had the whole movie motif and it was John Cena versus Triple H again, and they actually wrestled and they were good.
Mm.
It was I was like, because the entire night, you guys were like, oh, it's going to be a good match. So I'm like, I couldn't give a shit less. And then I was like...
I just got to mention, Sonic Screwjob in the chat room. Chachi knows about indie wrestling.
He's just nodding his head and saying, yeah, absolutely.
Listen, I know about indie wrestling when it matters. The AON report matters. All the other bullshit that you talk about in a half-hour indie wrestling minute... Bullshit. No one cares.
Oh, wow. I mention Chikara every once in a while.
Hey, since we have our old buddy Doc Remedy now wrestling, what's the Shad doing?
He's going in the WWE Hall of Fame!
Oh, I'm so glad to see that after he had all the sex with my Lita on the screen there. That was what's Lita doing? Is she
had the sex?
Yeah,
she's popping up. She got arrested for was it speeding or DUI?
I think it was DUI.
Well, I bet she's probably pretty yearning whenever she comes out of there. Which jail was she in?
She was in there for like a night.
What jail is she in?
Yeah, she's out
in Georgia.
Already.
No, she's out already.
Yeah. And she popped up in Slamversity. But no, for real, Edge is being inducted into the Hall of Fame.
Well, what
Holy shit, that was quick.
He had, like, he got a real concussion or something.
Yeah, he got an injury. He got a career-ending injury. And made it past WrestleMania and said, okay, I do have to call it quits.
You know,
so he's had neck surgery in the past, of course. I think related to that. So,
well, I remember he was actually one of the heels that I liked.
Mm-hmm.
I know whenever he started with that whole rated R superstar thing, you guys were you guys were already sick of Edge by the time they got to that point, but I was like, he's turning the page.
And it got great.
And he was really, he was one of those heels that I wanted to see.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Which the WWE so can't do anymore. The only way they can pull that off is if they get the guy that can do it without the WWE.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And that seems to be a lot of the things that the WWE, I honestly think it's, they do this thing where they try and push people. Like with the Rob Conway.
Mm-hmm.
They wanted him to work. He wasn't working. And so they just gave up. It's honestly like they just throw shit at a wall and whatever sticks, they go, that's us. That's us.
And the other ones going into the Hall of Fame, of course, are the rest of the Four Horsemen. No word.
So does that really mean that Rick's going to get a second ring?
I don't know.
Doesn't matter. And he should get another one because Ric Flair's greatest of all time. If you're ever having a bad day, go on YouTube and look up old Ric Flair promos. Your life will change for the better.
That's what made me love Ric, his old promos.
What was that thing about an alligator?
Oh, he had a promo. He's getting all excited. And at one point, he's just stomping his feet. He's like, I'm having a hard time keeping these alligators down. And he's just stomping back and forth. And it was one of the greatest things ever said in a promo.
Nice. Actually, I'm pretty sure Ric
Flair's
amazing.
No, Ric Flair's amazing. I don't know. He could have one ring on each finger
for making the careers of the Four Horsemen. I really don't care.
Actually, I'm pretty sure it does mean that he gets inducted again.
Does it?
Because, I mean, it's two separate categories.
It was weird. It was a little weird. If you want to parse that promo we saw last night, because it said four men, and, of course, J.J. Dillon's in there as well, and even the last picture they showed was all of the horsemen except Flair, including J.J. Dillon. So,
is that just the original four members then?
I think it is.
It's only going to be the originals because, right. One, that means they'd have to induct Steve McMichael. Two, they would have to induct Canadian wrestler X.
And Lex Luger.
And
Sting.
Lex Luger. And Sting. Man. Sting was a horseman at one point.
For like a month.
For like a month. Okay.
Before they turned on him and beat him up.
Roma.
And Paul Sid Vicious.
Yeah, do we want Paul Roma?
Paul Roma, Sid Vicious.
Do we want Romeo Paul Roma in the
Hall of Fame?
Macho Man is not in the Hall of Fame. Therefore, the whole Hall of Fame doesn't count.
A lot of people.
I'm surprised they didn't throw Macho Man in first inductee. They gave it to Edge and not Macho Man, which is bullshit.
Well, I heard... now, again, this is just wanton rumor that I've heard on the internet that he's never going to get in because Vince McMahon hates him maliciously because he slept with Stephanie.
Yes.
Yeah, that's
he better hate the whole damn roster.
We've heard the same rumor, except he slept with Stephanie when she was like 12.
Who cares? I'd hit that.
Who cares?
No.
I mean, again, honestly, Vince McMahon can't get it worse enough. And if it requires the entire fucking WWE roster using his 12-year-old daughter as a sperm dumpster, so fucking be it.
Holy shit.
Actually, Matt Mike. That makes a good point. That would be a nice way to do it.
Yeah.
Put Macho and Liz in at the same time.
Hell, use his 12-year-old son. I don't give a shit.
No, we're still talking about him fucking Stephanie.
Anyone could fuck Stephanie.
I'd tap it.
Yeah, exactly. Nobody would.
Speaking of that, yeah, Sorg, do you want to put those pictures up?
I'm on the life for that. Speaking of Stephanie, there you go. She was in a Muscle magazine. I can't tell you which one because the article I found with the pictures is in Espanol. Translate. Thank you, Google.
Well, yeah, but she's still L-clothed, so who gives a shit?
Yeah, L-clothed?
Wait. Bam! That's Triple H's back right there.
It is! Holy shit!
Well, at least they have the same workout regimen, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, she's still not as hot as Six. They're right, Lunchbox?
Oh!
There's... Ooh, Six?
Six.
Yep. You remember that wonderful video?
Six.
Blossom?
Oh, Six Blossom! Yes. Oh, Jesus, yes.
Wow.
So here's something I was thinking about I wanted to bring up. Now, did you guys partake in the China visit?
Oh, no.
I know we were talking about it, though.
I mean, how did you not do that? I mean, everyone could have chipped in. Gotten him a lap dance, gotten him beaten the tar and back, drive him to the friggin' hospital, and then he has a story to tell today.
I don't think my girlfriend would appreciate me coming home from the strip club with an STD.
Listen, I didn't say, well,
and
I guess.
Bruises.
I was going to say let, but I guess there's really no letting with China involved. But,
right.
But you can go, I'm pretty sure I saw a small penis there.
I've seen One Night in China. I'm pretty sure I saw a small penis there.
I mean, it's like a baby penis.
I'm pretty sure I saw two small penises in that porno.
Just two little ones.
I'm pretty sure while watching One Night in China, I saw two small penises in the same bed.
I honestly think that, I mean, that was almost more of a morbid curiosity than like... I mean, is anyone here? What?
Mike in the chat room said 1, 2, 3 inches.
All right, now does anyone
you know
here?
Let's end the show on that because we're not topping 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, let's go. Time's up.
Does anyone here or anyone on the chat room actually find China sexually attractive?
No. Now?
Right now.
And no.
Right, like, do you go, man, I need to dig out that old Playboy. Get my meat on.
First of all, I don't think I use that kind of term on.
That might be my new favorite phrase. You know what I
get my meat on.
Time for me to put on the old touching suit, get back in the old touching shed, let things run its natural course.
Speaking of touching sheds and China, China will be in a new porno called Ring Queen. It'll feature a ring, Titantron, and stars parodied, including Stephanie McMahon. It's out in March.
Wow. But so honestly, though, if you are...
That's just hilarity on a number of levels. Like, do the girls enter with ring music?
I hope so. Uh-huh. Pyrotechnics? Dildos everywhere?
Is the guy just standing there in the ring? He gets the jobber entrance?
Probably. I hope that he starts... maybe it could be a ladder match to a dick. Or a last dickings match. There you go.
You can finally have that KY ladder match you were talking about, Steve.
See,
two out of three guys.
Hot wax match? I don't know. There's a whole bunch of stuff. I could come up with sex matches all day.
And that is the title of the show. Sex matches
all day. So we can't go without we at least have to mention one thing about the TNA pay-per-view this past weekend. Friend of the show,
sure did happen.
Shima Zion, aka Zima Ion in TNA.
What was the name of the pay-per-view?
Genesis.
Yes.
Sega Genesis.
Sponsored by Sega.
Well, no, it was. It's January.
Oh.
So
God, that's so dumb. Honestly, the pay-per-view event titles are getting out of hand. Like, it's just, time to punch each other. Get it on. It's like, come on.
But, you know. But he was in a four-way match for the X Division title. Yeah. Pretty good match there to open up the pay-per-view. And didn't win the belt, but still a good match. And he also got dissed by one Rick Ross at ringside. AJ, you said he's been all over the place, right?
Yeah, they this one made the rounds on a bunch of rap blogs today. which was hilarious nonetheless because they're mentioning this guy and they're like, we don't know who the hell this guy is, but Rick Ross was there and gave him the finger and it was hilarious. He clowned this wrestler and I'm like, yeah, that guy's from West. That guy got trained in Pittsburgh.
Well, I can't find a picture of Shima, but there is a picture right there of Rick Ross at ringside. There you go. And
people were saying like, man, this is terrible. They're like, Rick Ross is at a wrestling pay-per-view and it's not even like a good one. And then people went, wait a minute, Master P actually wrestled. Never mind Rick Ross.
He had a tag team of No Limit Soldiers. The Kiss Demon. The Kiss Demon. Are you kidding me?
Yes.
Yeah, this is not the worst thing that's ever happened.
Remember when Vampiro was managed by the Misfits?
Oh, yeah.
What about whenever...
And they fought ICP.
Yeah, whenever ICP came in and won the WCW World Tag Championships.
Did they really?
Yeah, they won it. And then
they won them.
I couldn't remember.
But then they came out with Miracles, and they couldn't do that anymore, so...
All I gotta say
is a little further.
It RK.
What's that, Wittles?
I said, all I can say is David Arquette.
Aww. Kevin Federline.
You don't have to bring that up.
Kevin Federline, who has a win over John Cena. Yeah. And all I got to say, and all I got to go back to that makes it all feel better is Funkadelic Brodus Clay.
Yes.
All right.
Somebody call my mama.
Yeah, and it's actually the Cat's theme song.
Was that what they used?
Yeah, it's somebody called my mama.
Jeez. Well, they own the rights, I guess. So, there you go. On that note, I think we've learned so very much from this week in wrestling. But what did you learn, guys? What did you learn this week in wrestling, WrestleFan?
I learned from
Shut up! I'm sorry, I had to. Go ahead. Sorry. Go for it.
I learned
and
from
you
this
turned
week
me,
in wrestling.
I thought you turned me down.
I learned from this week in wrestling that there's nothing hotter than Tamina eating an apple with a paring knife. Just saying.
Wow. Okay. That's a WWE.com thing, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. LB, what'd you learn from wrestling this week?
Wrestling this week? Fuck you. I learned from 6 years of Mayhem Show.
Okay.
It's amazing, 6 years. The only other thing I've done consistently for the past 6 years is jerk off. So two things, jerking off and Wrestling Mayhem Show. And if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go put my dick in a chocolate cake and pretend it's karma.
It goes together like apple pie in America. AJ, what'd you learn from wrestling?
I learned that the best getaway vehicle that Zack Ryder could come up with was a lime green Kia Soul, which is a poor choice of getaway vehicle because it has neither the horsepower nor torque to get away from a 6'10" big red machine.
Who uses telekinetic powers?
He doesn't break the 7-foot.
He has the power to call fire via mind control. Your Kia Soul and its hamsters aren't going to do shit for that.
Wheels, what'd you learn from wrestling this week?
Oh, what did I learn? I've learned you can enjoy a song until you see a video pop up and just kills it for you.
You have to go listen to Gold to see what that's about, guys. And let's go over to Chachi of ChachiPlays.com.
Actually, we're going to go to the chat room first.
We're going to go to the chat room. What's going on in the chat
room? All right, Sonic Screwjob learned that he's the only guy that didn't get Brodus Clay. Riz learned that when he was younger, Break the Walls Down played when Chris Jericho was sent to his room.
That's awesome.
Bobby FJ Town learned how not to change a tire, how not to dance, how to cry like a man with a sparkly jacket, how to almost throw up in a Google Hangout, and he learned a lot about himself.
Mostly on that
also,
last part.
Yes. Also, Mad Mike learned that Daniel Bryan and Kurt Angle need to have a celebration off. And Matt Kirtland's learned that Yoshi Mania is running wild.
On you, brother.
Awesome.
Also, I learned that, and I don't know if you guys have been to a Penguins game, but if Evgeny Malkin scores a goal, they play Hulk Hogan in the ring going, what you going to do, brother, when Malkin Mania runs wild on you?
Nice.
Probably
they actually have that
in the other team to score. Now,
and so they still do the double Kennedy.
Kennedy.
Yeah.
That's cool.
What I learned from wrestling this week. Well, we can probably expect another 4 weeks of shitty Jericho appearances in Raw.
Yeah.
Just to match the 6 weeks of awesome promos they did leading up to this.
Did he see a shadow last week?
No, he touched the microphone, started crying, and left.
Nothing's changed. That's
so, yeah.
Steam, when'd you learn from wrestling?
I learned that if you have China give you a lap dance, bring a tag partner. Which, on top of that, Lunchbox, why didn't we ever come up with the tag name Steamed Lunch?
Oh, man.
That's perfect.
Oh, damn.
That's the best thing that's ever been.
Like, we literally fought and struggled for like 6 months coming up with a tag title name. And we came up with like something, I don't even remember. Like that.
Disciples of Destruction? Or
no, something like Viking Wisp, but like Steamed Lunch. There. Oh, Lords of Valhalla. Yeah.
That's what incredible. The fuck was that?
I liked Vikings at the time. All right, I don't know.
Don't judge him.
From 6 years of Mayhem.
A lot of Hero Clicks, and ooh. I think he got the Viking set.
Or Box Machine, that would work too.
Box Machine. Yeah.
So from 6 years of Mayhem, I learned that we can go from the back room of a duplex with 12 listeners on streaming internet radio to thousands of hits in your basement across town every week. And nothing really changes.
Nothing really changes.
That's another thing I've learned.
Thousands of hits in Sorg's basement. Yeah.
What's that?
From the transition over the years, I have learned from this show that I prefer shiny gold and teal mics to the crappy mics that come with the computer.
That is true. I mean, you remember. I mean, you this is new. This is the first. You haven't been here for 4 years.
I haven't seen this frigging like sex cage.
what was the layout when you used to come to do the show?
Whenever I came to do the show, there was a couch with a big hole in it with a spring that would gouge me in the ass, which is the only thing that kept me awake most of the time.
It was upstairs.
It wasn't even in this house.
Here it was upstairs.
Here it was upstairs.
But then we literally had the white gateway mic that still just took the two plugs for whatever reason, even though it didn't have audio in or audio out, I guess. And so then it was me, Chad, and Dave like hurtling around it like it's a fucking sacred object or something. And of course you give goddamn Lunchbox over there his own mic, and you and him, you're both like sitting in chairs like we're comfortable and we could do the show all day. And I'm like, I'm hurting and but I like saying fuck, so keep going. Oh, man, the good old days.
Well, now you have your own mic.
I have my own mic.
Yeah.
That I am gonna, this is my mic. And now
I don't think that's it.
You can't take it with you.
No, I'm not going to take it. Okay. I'm just saying, when anyone else uses it, it's my mic.
Right.
Okay, and just hang a sign that says Steam's mic.
Yeah.
I think I was first dibs on that mic.
It doesn't give a shit!
I think I was the first one to get to use that mic.
You're in a TV, so it doesn't matter at all.
That's it. I'm booking a match, AJ versus Steam Machine.
I will eat you and think of some of those matches I came up with. All right, I'll do it.
Next story socket. Next story.
Listen
socket.
To me.
Steam
what
Lunch
I have here.
AJ and whoever the hell is
watching. I will climb the lube ladder and I will win the vase on top of the ladder. I will not break.
All right. Oh, hold on. Now I need to. Over to me. Okay. You think you can escape the jizz bucket? You cannot! I will fill it to the top. The meniscus will flow.
There you go.
And you will be showered in my seed.
You've been listening to Wrestling Mayhem Show, episode 303. You can find us on the Twitter. It's at Mayhem Show. You can go to WrestlingMayhemShow.com. We're on the Facebook. We have groups. Google Plus Hangout every Monday night for Raw. Hit us.
Yeah.
Circle us. No two girls, please. None of that. No freaky porn. Just come in and watch Raw with us.
Despite what you've heard here, yes. No freaky porn.
And you too can be part of the Wrestling Mayhem Show. You can email us at
goodtimes@wrestlingmayhemshow.com.
And as soon as Sorg puts up the number, I will read it to you because I don't know it.
416
WMS0. There we go. 967. No, I remember that part. I remember the last four digits. 967. But so Wrestling Mayhem Show, episode 303. Mayhem out!
Buddy out! Just wait. Just wait. Just wait. Just wait.